Hello friends, I am Sanjeev Sirsat and you are watching Genius Science YouTube channel. Friends, in this video we are going to discuss about class 10th subject Science and Technology.
Paper number 1.
Most important questions. Friends, it is must to do all syllabus for more and more scoring. But in this video we are going to discuss minimum syllabus, maximum scoring, maximum marks. Friends, each and every exam is important for us because the all type of exams are develop our career. So in this video we are going to discuss the most important questions. Please, if you are new on this channel, firstly subscribe the channel, press bell icon, like, share, and remember, if you have any type of difficulty, you type in comment box. I will make a good video on that your difficulty, and your difficulty will be solved. Friends, then see the which are the important questions and points in science first paper.
Then friend, we are going to discuss about the important points question or beat from Science and Technology paper number 1st. Friends, we are going towards chapter number 1st, Gravitation. It is important chapter for 12th examination also and for NEET examination. In the chapter Gravitation, Circular Motion, Kepler's Laws of Planetary Motion, Universal Law of Gravitation are important beats. Also, uniform circular motion or effect of centripetal force. This is also important for 12th exam, 12th syllabus also. Earth's gravitation force, Earth's gravitational acceleration, value of G on the surface of Earth. This unit we must learn in different heads. That is the gravitation changes. That is the change in the gravitation at depth, at height, due to the altitude, latitude, then gravitational potential energy and escape velocity of satellite or any other. The next chapter is periodic classification of elements. This chapter is also important for 12th class as well as NEET G examination. Friends, in this chapter, Dobbenheim writes Newland's law of octaves. These definitions or laws we must to remember. Then properties of Mendeleev's periodic table. Drawbacks of Mendeleev's periodic table as well as the merits of this Mendeleev's periodic table. Modern periodic table in its long form. Structure of periodic table. Periods and electronic configuration. Periods in terms of periods and in terms of rows. And their classifications. That periods. Then periodic trends in modern periodic table. What is the trends? Then left to right, that is the change in atomic size, properties of metals, gradation in a halogen family, that is different trends in these periodic tables. We must learn that is the change or decrease from left to right or right to left in the periodic table. The next chapter is that is the chemical reactions and equations. In the chapter chemical equations, balancing a chemical equation, how we can balance the chemical equation in case of reactant and in case of product, where are the reactants and where are the products, the total number of atoms on left side and total number of atoms on right side. This is the balancing of chemical equations. Then steps in balancing a chemical reactions, how we can balance the chemical reaction. Types of chemical reactions, you know, there are the different types of chemical reaction, that's the combination reaction, decomposition, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction, oxidation and reduction. These types of reactions also we must remember. Then endothermic and exothermic process and reactions. What is the endothermic process? What is the exothermic process? Or what is the endothermic reaction? What is the exothermic reaction? Where the reaction can release the heat or where it can take the heat from the surrounding. Then the rate of chemical reactions. There is the change in rate of chemical reaction, that may be decrease or increase. Why the chemical reactions may decrease or why the chemical reactions may increase. And which the rate of chemical reactions and the factors affecting the rate of chemical reaction. There are the different factors. and that factors are size of particles of reactant, the temperature, surrounding temperature. There are the different points you must to remember these. Then the next chapter is effect of electric current. In this chapter, when we can pass the current in the conductor, that conductor can shows the different effects, that magnetic effect, light effect, sound effect, and different types of effect. But here, electric current, we are going to learn the heating effect of electric current, magnetic effect of electric current, right hand thumb rule, magnetic field due to a current in solenoid. Solenoid means this is the solenoid. Okay, then flaming left hand rule, electric motor, you know, electric motor, how electric motor can works, when we can pass the current through the coil which is fitted in the electric motor, that coil generates the magnetic field, and due to that magnetic field, that rotor can rotates and there is formation of mechanical energy. Then electronic electromagnetic induction, electromagnetic induction, mutual induction and self induction. Then Fleming's right hand rule, alternating current AC and direct current DC, and electric generator. Friends, this electric generator is also important to us because it is very very useful to us, and it is also in 12th class also. The next chapter is heat. In heat chapter, we must learn, we must to remember latent heat, anomalous behavior of water, dew point and humidity, and specific heat capacity. These are the important bit from this heat chapter. The next chapter is refraction of light. Friends, in refraction of light, refractive index. What is the refractive index? It is the ratio of sin I by sin R. Means angle of incidence, you know, this is the angle of we have incident this rays, the angle of incidence I and angle of refraction R. The ratio of these two terms, the sin I by sin R, is the refractive index. We must remember this. Dispersion of light, partial and total internal refraction. Partial and total internal reflection. Total internal reflection is useful for OFC, OFC optical fiber cable, you know, side of the roads, there are the so many pipes are buried, and in that buried there is a passing of small tubes, that tubes are called as OFC. Friends, next chapter is lenses and their uses. Then center of curvature, principal axis, optical center, principal focus, focal length, these definitions are important. Then the sign conventions, then lens formulae, magnification, power of lens, combination of lenses, these are the important terminology or terms from the lenses. And next one is the application based bit in the chapter is human eye. Then we must to learn about the human eye, in detail about the human eye in the chapter, and working of its lens. You know, there is one lens in our eye, that lens can works as like the physical lenses. Then defects of visions and their corrections. You know, defect of visions are nearsightedness, that is called as myopia, farsightedness, that is hypermetropia, and presbyopia. These are the terms most important for examination, for the view of examination. Uses of concave lenses and concave lenses also, and simple microscope and compound microscope. These are the important bit from this lens chapter. We give most emphasis on these units or in this, on these bits. 8th chapter is metallurgy. Friends, this metallurgy is also important chapter. In this chapter, we must learn chemical properties of metals. Chemical properties. Then reactions of metals. There are the different types of reactions. That are the reaction of metals with oxygen, reactions of metals with water, reaction of metals with dilute acid, reaction of metal with nitric acid, reactions of metal with salts of other metals that are also metals, but their salt solutions. And here most important unit of the chapter is reactivity series. This is also important. Chemical properties of non-metals, ionic compounds and their properties. Then the basic principles of metallurgy. Which are the basic principles? That are concentration of ores, separation based on gravitation. Listen, concentration of ores. We can concentrate the ores with the help of separation on based gravitation based. Then wheel fly table method, hydraulic separation method, magnetic separation method and froth flotation methods. From these units we must to learn froth flotation is the most important. Then this is the wheel fly method and gravitation based method and magnetic separation method. These are the important bits from this chapter. Extraction of aluminium. This is one example from metallurgy, aluminium. The concentration of ore, how we can concentrate the aluminium ores, and then electronic reduction of alumina, then prevention of corrosion. This is also important bit from the chapter. That is the galvanizing, tanning, anodizing, electroplating, alloys. These are the important bit from this chapter. The next one is the carbon compounds. Hydrocarbons, saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons, functional group in organic compounds, homologous series, IUPAC nomenclature system, you know, International Union Pure and Applied Chemistry. There are the three steps of nomenclature, IUPAC nomenclature. We must to learn this and we must to remember this. Chemical properties of carbon compounds, that chemical properties are combustion, oxidation, addition reaction, substitution reaction. These are the important bits. Then important carbon compounds, which are that ethanol and ethanoic acid. We remember this. Then chemical properties of ethanol, that is reaction with sodium, dehydration reaction. These are the most important reactions. Then chemical properties of ethanoic acid, that are the reaction with base and esterification reaction. This is the important reaction from this chapter, esterification reaction. Then next chapter is the 10th chapter and last chapter. Then we are going to discuss about the important points from 10th chapter. Space mission, needs and importance of space mission, artificial satellite, orbits of artificial satellites. There are the different types of orbits that are depend on height of satellite from the surface of Earth, satellite launch vehicles, that is PSLV, as like PSLV, that is the Polar Satellite Launching Vehicle, moon missions, Mars missions, missions to the other planets. Friends, these are the most important bits from science and technology paper number first. Friends, I think you may like this chapter, you may like this video. Please comment, like and share this video to our friends, and you must to introduce or give the introduction to this YouTube channel, Genius Science YouTube channel, to your dear. Then we can stop for this video. Thank you.